In this video, I'll show you how to add related articles to a blog article on your Shopify store. This is a useful way to help users continue reading your content if they're on your site. It can also be helpful for SEO to interlink your articles and help Google crawl from one article to the next. In this tutorial, I'll be using the Superstore theme, and the code that I'll provide in this tutorial will work in Superstore. It will not work in other themes, but you can take the code and modify it fairly easily to work in other themes. If you need any help with that or with anything else, you can visit us at envision.io. All right, let's jump in. To start, go to Online Store Themes, and here you'll see your theme library, your currently published theme at the top, and then your unpublished themes below. If your site is getting live traffic, I recommend working in an unpublished copy of your theme. And you can duplicate your live theme by clicking the three dots button and duplicate, and then rename it with today's date if you want to, and then work in the unpublished copy here. My site's not getting live traffic yet, so I'll work directly in the live theme. So first click on the three dots button and go to the code editor. Then scroll down to the sections folder in the sidebar and add a new section. Leave it as the liquid option here rather than JSON. The file name can be whatever you want it to be, but to be consistent with the naming structure of the other sections, I'm going to call it dynamic related articles. Next, open up the code, and I'll link to this code in the video description below, and select all and copy, and then select all of the existing code in the section that we just created and paste to replace it. And save. All right, that's all the code we have to work with for now. The next thing is to set up the metafield definitions. So we're going to use metafields to assign the related articles that we want to show for each individual blog article. And we'll do that using the handles of each related article. So we go back to our settings and custom data. And this is where our metafield definitions are. And we're going to add a definition to the blog posts area. So click add definition. The name can really be whatever you want it to be. But if you just type in related articles, that'll give you the correct namespace and key to work with the code that we've already written. If you do give it a different name, just make sure that the namespace and key match this. It should be custom.related_articles. The type field here, choose single line text, and then choose list of values. And save. So now that we've created that metafield definition, if we close out of our settings and go to one of our blog posts, I've got four sample blog posts here. We're going to use sample blog post one, and we want to show posts 2, 3, and 4 as related articles. So if you look at the front end of this blog post currently, down at the bottom, there are no related articles, but it does show us the previous article link. And this is just a native feature of Superstore. If you click previous article, it takes you to blog post 2, and then you see these previous and next links for 1 and 3. But we want to add a new section below that that shows related articles. So if we open up sample blog post 1, scroll down to the bottom, you'll see a metafields box. Click show all, and here's that field that we just created for related articles. And if you click inside that field, the thing that you want to put here is the handle of whatever article or articles you want to show as related articles. So I want to show blog post 2 as a related article for blog post 1. So I need to grab the handle for blog post 2. So I'm going to open this in a new tab. So the handle is in the URL up here. It's everything after blogs/news or whatever your blog handle is, slash. So it's after the final slash, everything after that is the handle for the article. So grab that handle, come back here and paste it in like that. And if you want to add multiple articles, just click add item until you have the number of fields that you want. So we're going to add a total of 3 related articles. So now I need the handles for blog posts 3 and 4. Here's the handle for blog post 3. And 4. So this field, related articles, is uniquely attached to each blog article. So if you come in to look at blog post 2, that field will be blank because we haven't attached any related articles to blog post 2 yet. So far, we've only done it on blog article 1. And we've attached articles 2, 3, and 4 as related articles. The last step is to go into our theme customizer and add the section that we just pasted the code in for to the article template. So you want to click the customize button and then navigate to your article page. You can do that by clicking the drop down at the top here that by default will say home page. Go to your blog posts, submenu, and then default blog post. And then over in the sidebar, you'll see an option to add a section. Click that and then choose related articles. And this is showing up here because of the code that we copied and pasted into our new section a minute ago. So we now have this related articles heading, but the articles aren't showing up yet. So we have to click inside the section. You can change the heading if you want to. You can change the font colors, spacing, but we need to choose which blog we want it to work with. So we have one blog currently, the news blog, and we just have to select that here. And now that we've selected it, we can see that it's pulling in those related articles, and it's using the metafields that we attached a minute ago. So now if we go back to the front end, and refresh, we'll see those related articles showing up here. So the last thing that I'll do is clean up this layout a little bit. The spacing is a little bit off. There's a little bit too much space between the heading and the articles. And then also, because I'm already showing related articles here, I don't really want to show this previous article link. You can leave it if you want to, but I'm going to hide it, and you can choose whether or not you want to do that. So to adjust the spacing here, there is a spacing setting in the section here, but this applies to the space above and below the overall section. So it's above the related articles heading and below the articles here. So if we reduce this from 50 pixels down to, let's say 20, all that does is move the heading up closer to this previous article link. So I'm gonna leave it at 40 for now, but we need to reduce the spacing in here. Now, if your articles have featured images where each article is showing a thumbnail image here, which it will if you've attached a thumbnail or a featured image, then you might not need to adjust the spacing. So it's really up to you if you wanna do this next step. But what we'll do is on the front end, go to the related article section and go to one of the blog article headings. So I'll go to blog post 2, right click, and then go to inspect. And we need to find the class to target. So if I hover over this div here, it says article dash dash excerpt dash content. And you can see that green padding above the, or margin above the blog post there. And that's the spacing that I want to reduce. So if I click on that div, over here, I'm going to move myself out of the way. Over here, you'll see this CSS here, padding top 4.5 rem plus change. So we want to grab this class here and copy it. And then we're going to use that in just a minute. But first, let's figure out how much padding we actually want. So let's change this 4.5. Let's change that to 2.5. And you'll see that immediately bumps these articles up a good bit. And I might just go ahead and remove all of these decimal points here and just leave it at 2 rem. And I think that looks pretty good. So let's leave it at that. Now, this change that I made in my inspector is not actually affecting the site code. It's just a preview. So we need to actually add the CSS into the theme. And the easiest way to do that is in the theme settings. So make sure you have this class copied that we copied a minute ago. Come back into your theme customizer here. And then on the related article section, look down at the bottom for this custom CSS block. Open that up and then paste the class in here that we just copied. And then add a space and curly brackets and type padding dash top colon to rem semicolon. And you'll see that that just applied that change by bumping up those articles. So now we can save it. And let's refresh on the front end and make sure that that change is still working. All right, that seems to have worked. So the final thing I'll do here is I want to get rid of this previous article link. So in a similar approach to what we did a second ago, I'm going to right click on this and inspect it. And I want to find this div here, article dash dash pagination. And just to test this out, I'm going to add a style here, display colon none. And that hit it, so that's what I want. I might play around with the spacing above and below this related article's heading a bit more, but that's the main thing I wanted to do was hide this pagination. So again, I need to copy this class, come back to my custom CSS field here, paste it in like this, add curly brackets, and type display colon none, and then end it with a semicolon. And let's refresh and see if that worked on the front end. So sometimes the custom CSS field here in Shopify doesn't accept changes that we make. It's like there are rules about what kind of changes you can and can't make. So if that is the case, if it doesn't seem to work, then you can copy this. I'll cut it out. I'll go back to my code editor. And we'll open up our style sheet, which is in the assets folder. So go to assets, and then theme.css.liquid. Scroll down to the very bottom, start a new line, and paste the code in there. And let's refresh and see if that worked. All right, that worked. So now our related articles section is showing up. We removed the pagination and we're good to go. So from here then we can go into any other article as well and add metafields in the exact same way. So again, we go back to blog posts, open up an article, scroll down to the bottom to the metafields box, and then just paste in the handles of any article that you want to show as a related article.